Hey, I'm Jake from Modern Baseball.
Hi, I'm Sean.
I'm Ian.
We're at Amoeba Records, and this is
What's in My Bag.
I'm Brendan. Okay. I did two movie soundtracks. Boom. Did It Follows in Jurassic Park. Jurassic Park is my favorite movie, and I've been trying to grab this for a while. Also, the alternative artwork is seriously amazing. And we've been on like a horror movie kick on this tour. Everyone who can't watch horror movies goes to bed, and then we like try to start one, but we're usually too tired.
This is Ellie and Lane's Make Out of Bed Voices. I didn't get into this band until like 3 months ago, and the only way I could do it was by listening to the Greatest Hits record.
With most members in their mid-30s, Guided by Voices are into 60s British rock as much as 90s alternative. But frontman Robert Pollard, until recently a fourth grade teacher, doesn't think age will affect how audiences respond to their music.
First, I have a record by a band called The Pointed Sticks. This was a cool power pop band in the late 70s. Not entirely sure whether they were named after the Monty Python sketch, but I'm gonna just go out on a limb and say it's probably named after the Monty Python sketch.
Oh, 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 we want to learn how to defend ourselves against pointed sticks, do we?
This is the Fortress Sofa Club. When I let you die. The songwriter is Sean Harris, who actually is the singer of the band The Matches, who's actually one of my favorite bands. They were kind of too weird for their time. He makes such interesting arrangements, but like still with a pop hook.
That's some wacky art there.
I got the Indiana Jones collection.
Nice.
Because I needed it.
Don't look around! Keep your eyes shut!
I've been borrowing my friend Belcourt's for a really long time now, and I feel really bad. He was like, can you please bring it back to me before you leave? And I was like, you got it, man. And then watched Raiders and then didn't bring it back. Also got Steve Jobs.
Wait, which one is that?
This is the good
That's
one.
That's the good one, okay, cool.
I don't have a daughter named Lisa. And this story is now about how I'm denying paternity and took a blood test. And that's why there's a picture of, I don't know what the fuck that is. That's why there's a picture of a PC on the cover instead of a picture of me and the Mac.
Aaron Sorkin, who did like West Wing, he's like one of my favorite screenwriters, I would say. I love Michael Fassbender so much, and yeah. Kate Winslet. This movie was definitely like for me. He's kind of mean and manic.
Yeah. He's not that likable of a guy for a lot of the movie.
Yeah.
Which is weird.
Which is probably my favorite part of his character.
Yeah. This is a national record. I only ever heard about like older people listening to this band, so for some reason for a really long time I was like, that band's for old people. But then I heard this record and I was like, oh, I like this. I'm 22. Also, their drummer is like, I found out, one of my favorite drummers, because he hardly ever uses cymbals at all. Mainly just like closed hi-hat and like a bunch of tom stuff, but he keeps everything really interesting, which is weird to do without all that stuff.
Yeah.
Next record I have is by a band called The Only Ones. No, I think I'm on another world with you.
With you. I'm on another planet with you. With you.
another planet.
Late 70s, around the time of like The Clash and The Damned, had one hit, Another Girl, Another Planet, that like
made famous by Blink-182.
Made famous by Blink-182 on their greatest hits. I think I'm on another world
with you. This is Flogging Molly's Drunken Lullabies. Cause we find ourselves in the same old mess. Singing drunken lullabies. Oh, maybe it's the way we talk. Oh, maybe it's the way we fuck. I've always kind of had a fascination with like trad music. They're one of the few bands who kind of integrate it into modern music and punk music so well. Everything's so big. Like, yeah. There's so much instrumentation on there.
Yeah.
And another reason I got this is because this year, me and my fiance went on the Flogging Molly cruise, the Salty Dog cruise. Shout out to all my shipmates out there.
That's a real thing.
Yeah.
Salty Dog cruise is a 3-day party put together by Flogging Molly. On the weekend of St. Patrick's Day, we raise our glasses and we sail away. Music, friendship, drinking, dancing, a punk rock gig on a tropical island.
The really only musical thing I got.
Nice.
Big parking cards.
Boom. Dunner, rapper done right, an extinguished crotch of a roller inside,
yellow fingers, nothing lasts, but nearly everything lingers in life. This record's awesome. It's our drummer Sean's favorite record of the year. This is actually the first Parquet Courts record that I'm buying.
I bought like 4 at that show. They had all of them.
Wait, and this one?
Yeah.
Jeez Louise. Yeah,
it was the only time I like spent a lot of money. These are Pedro the Lion records.
Wow. I saw in your bedroom the drawers had been empty, looking for answers, but you won't admit it now.
I think this is my favorite Pedro the Lion record. I really like Pedro the Lion. They're one of my favorite bands. Next record I have is Blonder and Blonder by The Muffs. '90s pop punk band, kind of in the same vein as Green Day. This record actually sounds really Green Day. It was done by Rob Cavallo. This was another band that I thought was like absolutely fantastic, and there's no reason why The Muffs didn't get huge with like Hole, because these pop hooks are insane. Kim writes the best pop punk hooks of any band, except maybe D4.
No, dude, they steal all their songs from Green Day, you know that. This is a record by a band called Module Lee. Get him home! Please give me something to do! Yeah, this band, they're just like an awesome punk band. They played our album release for Sports, our first record,
which
we did in Michael Jordan house, where a bunch of us were living at the time. They were like the like headliner of it. We're like, can we get Module Lee to play this?
Yeah, we were really stoked.
And they played it, and they're just like awesome dudes.
Great people.
Great people.
Great tunes.
And I just can't believe it made it all the way out here. This rocks.
Are you done?
I'm done.
Wow, so it's just me now?
Yeah, well, you said you only had one left.
I do. I only have one thing left, and it's the 30th anniversary Ultimate Edition of Close Encounters of the Third Kind. Something I did
Ultimate
not...
Ultimate Edition?
Yeah, did I stutter? I love this movie so much. One of my favorite sci-fi movies. I feel like there's a lot of finesse behind it. Probably gonna wait until everyone falls asleep tonight and watch this.
I have one more record, and it's Built to Spill, There's Nothing Wrong with Love. Wanna see their faces turn to backs of heads and slowly get smaller. Wanna see it now. One of my favorite records of all time, released in the magical year for music, 1994. Choice tunes on it,
Built to Spill, classic band.
I like that one song that you play on bass at Soundcheck.
That's Modest Mouse.
Oh. Oh, so this is Paul Blart Mall Cop. Get up, everybody's gonna move their feet. Get down, everybody's gonna move their feet. First and I drink, then I smoke. I got the car, Kevin James, I love his humor so much. Yeah,
choice film.
Just a great mix of physical humor and, you know, themes of the modern mall. And it's set in West Orange, New Jersey, which my dad is from, so close to home. But it's not a real mall there. It's based upon the Willowbrook Mall, which was the mall I used to go to growing up.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Thank you
yeah.
for having us.
Yeah, seriously. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'll be with you the whole way. It'll take time. That's
that. I'm not just another face. I'm not just. Amoeba.